Hey and welcome to the channel. In this video I'm going to talk about troubleshooting Windows 11 and all the different tools you can use. Let's load up Control Panel. First, we are going to look at automatic maintenance. This feature runs routine cleanups and updates to optimize performance, including disk cleanup, software updates and system scans. You can schedule it to run at convenient times. Now let's take a look at recovery and all the different options available. Let's start by clicking recovery. Let's click configure system restore. As you can see, system protection is off. Let's configure and turn on system protection. When we click Open Restore, we can see we don't have any restore points, so let's create one. Let's click Create and I will use today's date for the name. Let's click on System Restore and we'll be able to see what we created earlier. You can check on what programs have changed since the last restore point. Now let's take a look at reliability history, found under security and maintenance. Reliability history provides a timeline of system stability, listening to events, warnings and errors, helpful for tracking down root cause of system instability, like application crashes. Double click and you can find out more about the issues. Now let's take a look at another day and have a look at this critical error. Now let's take a look at Event Viewer. Event Viewer records system events, providing logs for different categories. For example, system, application and security. Each log offers detailed event information. Use this to diagnose and troubleshoot issues and application errors and or hardware failures. Now let's take a look around at the different information we can see. Let's create a custom view where you can pick a range of different times, events, and much more. Now let's run the custom view and see what errors it brings up. Thank you. Now you can see all the details about this critical error. Now let's load up control panel again and have a look at the Windows built-in troubleshooters. First of all, let's have a look at recommended troubleshoot history. As you can see, we haven't run any troubleshooters before on this device. Now let's take a look at other troubleshooters. You can now see all the different options you can choose from. We are going to pick network and internet, even though the connection is fine. We are going to run the troubleshooter and see what happens. In the bottom right, you can see the network connection is being restarted. You can run other troubleshooters such as Bluetooth, camera, and video playback. Now let's take a look at Task Manager. It displays active processes, system performance, startup programs, and much more. Under processes on the left-hand side, you can see CPU usage, memory usage, disk, and network. You can also check background processes, you can end them and find where they are installed on the device. Now let's take a look at performance. Lots of useful information to see here, and you can also see the uptime of the device. Now let's take some time to have a look over app history. You can see things like CPU time, network, and much more. Now let's have a look at startup apps. These are apps that load on startup. For this video, I have disabled Microsoft Teams. You can also load up properties from here and find out information such as version number, etc. Let's take a look at users, where you can see a list of users who are currently logged in, what applications they are using, and you can also log them out. When we click details, you can see a list of what is running in the background. You can also click applications and set different priority levels. Let's check out services. You can see a list of all the services on the device. You can see what is running or what has been stopped. Let's check Windows updates and let's restart the service. The System File Checker tool, accessed via a command, is a built-in Windows utility that scans for and repairs corrupted or missing system files. It is especially useful for resolving issues where the system files have been modified, deleted, or corrupted, potentially causing instability or functionality problems in Windows.
This will take a couple of minutes to run.
As you can see, corrupt files have been found and they have been successfully repaired. If errors cannot be repaired, try this command. It's a powerful tool for repairing and maintaining the integrity of the Windows operating system image. Now let's take a look at Device Manager. Device Manager lists all connected hardware and their drivers, allowing users to troubleshoot hardware issues, update outdated drivers, disable malfunctioning devices, or uninstall and reinstall drivers. You can also roll back drivers too. Now let's keep the hardware theme going and test our RAM with the memory diagnostic tool. Click restart and this will take around 20 minutes depending on how much memory you have installed on the system. As you can see, no errors are found. Now let's take a look at advanced startup options and repair options. Hold down the shift key and restart the device. We have a couple of different options here, but we are going to click troubleshoot. Let's click Advanced Options. You can perform a startup repair, uninstall updates, or go back to a restore point, and much more. Reset this PC is a recovery option that reinstalls Windows while keeping personal files, which is useful for resolving severe system issues without losing data. A great last resort option when other troubleshooting methods fail, as it reinstalls the operating system, retains documents, pictures and other files. We are going to select cloud download as this PC is connected to the internet. This will take around 30 minutes to install Windows again and you'll end up at the desktop once this is complete. As you can see, we are now back on the desktop. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, it really helps me grow the channel, and thanks for watching.